G'day, it's James here. Welcome to the channel. Today we have a video about Fully Kiosk Browser. We're going to install it on a tablet. We're going to mount it in a VitaBox wall mount and set it all up. This will give us a sweet central place to control Home Assistant from. Please check out the timestamps if you want to jump to a specific section or find the link to the written description below. Let's get started with how it's powered. Okay, so this is the little USB charger I started with. It takes a 24 volt input and it claims to charge up to 3 amps. I found that it didn't work. I got it off AliExpress and it just didn't keep the tablet charged. So I ditched this idea and went to something else. I got one of these mains voltage USB chargers. It has an output of 5 watts, sorry. And this one worked perfectly. So I've been using this one to charge the tablet. It's actually a pretty good little USB charger. You can put it in switch plates like this. You can have up to 6 in one wall plate. And it has little adapter plates, so you can use it on different brand switches. Clipsal, HBM, and Legrand XL Life. So it's a good little USB charger, and that's the one we're using on the tablet project today. Okay, so this is the tablet holder we're going to be using today. It's from VitaBox. They've got quite a big range of different wall mount tablets for different brands and models. I think this one is, they don't make it anymore, but there's a few left. It says limited numbers available. And we're just gonna go check it out. So this is how it came. I got 2 of them. It worked out to about $200 Australian, including delivery, to get it here. So the delivery was actually pretty pricey. And I got 2 of them at the time. And it comes with all the information and mounting accessories. So you can see perhaps that it's got a bit of a texture on it. So it's not smooth, but it looks quite nice, like it's got a nice finish and it looks very well made. It detaches and has these clips to clip it on with, like so. And it's got all the cutouts for the cords and all the buttons to go in, and it's got some little compression things to hold it in place. So this just gets mounted on the wall with these fixing holes just here. And the tablet goes inside and can be connected up to the USB power supply inside. So we're gonna mount that on the wall now, and we're gonna install our tablet, and we're gonna put Fully Kiosk Browser on there to set it up for Home Assistant. For this video, I'm using a Samsung Galaxy Tab A7, which is brand new, but it was quite an old model of 2016. It works okay. I've been using it for a few weeks and it's fine. The only thing is it's a little bit slow. As Fully Kiosk detects motion though, it makes it quite usable, as the screen will turn on as you approach it, and the Home Assistant interface is preloaded, so it's ready to go straight away. So it makes it quite good and easy to use. If you want to use a similar setup like this with your Home Assistant or your home automation, then I recommend downloading Fully Kiosk onto your tablet, and definitely go ahead and buy the paid version. I think it's only $6 a once off cost. It's an excellent program with heaps of settings. The only thing is it's no good for Apple devices. It's only for Android. Now, once you've got it downloaded and installed on your tablet, in Fully Kiosk, there's lots of settings you can set up, but mainly you want to go in and turn on remote access. So you can do that if you go to settings, remote administration plus, and then turn on the first 5 toggles and set a password. If you want, there's a cloud service, but I haven't personally used that yet. But once it's all set up, you can go ahead and put it into your wall mount, and all other settings you can change remotely via the remote terminal on your browser, on your computer. Now everything's installed and our tablet has power and the wall box is mounted. We can head over to the computer and see all the things we can set up in the browser and how we can link it into Home Assistant and control it with Home Assistant in different ways. Let's do that now. The remote access is configured. We can now go in and set it up via the remote access. Now these instructions I'll leave a link to in the description down below if you want to have a look at the written description and instructions. Basically what we do is we go to this address just here in a browser and we can go into the setup for our fully kiosk tablet. So we enter a password and this is the info screen just here. We can load the URL that we want to display on the tablet, so we can load whatever address we want in here, or we can reload the one that's programmed in. We can see what's on the screen at the moment remotely. You can see what the camera is looking at, and there's all these other settings too, whether the screen's on and the brightness. So one of the first things we want to do is head over to settings just here and go into web content, and we want to set our start URL. Now I've got a dashboard set up in Home Assistant, so if we come over here we can see configurations. We have dashboards and we can make one, different dashboards, which is a pretty cool new feature that's been recently added to Home Assistant. So I've got one set up for my tablet and you can change the dashboard by going to the user profile and selecting the dashboard you want it to use. So I've got that set up on my tablet to run this. And if we go to, and we just type that address in there so it loads that dashboard. So now we go back to the next one. So the next one is web browsing. So you may or may not want to enable pull to refresh. So when you pull the page down, it refreshes it. If your page has quite a bit of information on it and you have to scroll down to see more down lower, it doesn't. When you have pull to it and pull to refresh enabled, you can't go back up. So in some cases you may want this off. But if your page shows as just one page without having to go down, then it's okay to have that turned on. Enable the back button, so the actual button on the tablet will go back one page, and the same with the home button will load the start URL. So load those up. The next lot of settings is in web auto reload. I've just got auto reload page after an error, 60 seconds. And then the next lot of settings is advanced web settings. You just want to enable the keyboard and touch interface and scrolling and dragging. And then device management. So here we want to make sure the screen is kept on and the brightness, we can set it to whatever you like, up to 255. And the screen off timer. So that time just there is how long the screen will stay on and then it will time, will turn itself off. And it will come back on when it detects motion again. And then finally, it's launch on boot. If that's enabled, it means if the tablet is turned off, it'll launch and turn back on again. It will launch straight into kiosk mode and load Home Assistant. And kiosk mode plus, it's in here where we enable kiosk mode. So we want to pretty much turn on all of these. And it locks the tablet down so that people can't play with it and stuff up the tablet. So people come along and go, oh, it's not working. So turn all those on to lock it down. And then motion detection plus. So device movement is the actual physical moving of the device, which doesn't really apply in most cases for us. But motion detection, we want to turn that on. So the visual detection and set sensitivity, I've got mine set to 90 and frame rate to 5. And that, so when you walk up to it, that will turn on the tablet. And then after the 30 seconds, it'll time out or whatever time you've got set it for the timeout. The darkness level is for if it's in a room that's and the lights are off and you don't want the tablet to keep turning on, you can actually set it to not work in darkness. So you have to turn screen off in darkness here and set the threshold. I haven't got it turned on because it's in the kitchen. It doesn't matter if it's on or off. And there's also enable acoustic motion detection, and the sensitivity for the acoustic motion is just here. And then turn screen on motion. So that's an
important one to have, so that the screen will come on when it detects motion. And then last of, and so that's all the main settings that we have to set up. There's obviously others that you can set up. But if we go down to, if we browse to this page, substituting your IP address and password, we'll see all the settings. And we can use this in Home Assistant to set up a sensor to get information about our tablet. And if we go to this page, we can see an extended list of settings, and there's over 200 settings, and you can change all those values and they get applied immediately. So if we look at it in a browser, it's actually quite a lot. So you can also use a REST client, a REST client like this one that's built into Chrome. And if you browse on here, it gives you a list of all the keys, and you can actually use these keys in Home Assistant to change the settings as you wish. To change the settings, you can use this here. You can actually change it from a web browser if you want to. Basically, some are Boolean, so true or false, and some values are values. So it's set string, and then you set the value and set the password. So an example here is setting the motion sensitivity to 100. Now there's also commands that you can load. So you can load a URL other than the start one, just here, and the URL address, which is just there, it has to be encoded. So you can use a URL encoder, like, and you can type in the address and you put it in here, and I'll use this as an example, and you can encode it, and then you can use that encoded address where it says URL. And that way it'll work. And you can also trigger motion. You can start the URL, go load the start URL, and you can also restart the app, which with this one here. So I just restarted the app. And I use that in an automation to reset the tablet every morning. I found that my tablet was locking up every couple of days. And so if I restart it every morning, it stopped that problem, it's made it go away. So I've got it set up as an automation in Home Assistant to do that. Okay, so we can play sounds on our tablet. For instance, to alert, make an alert, or if someone rings the doorbell, we can play a sound on the tablet. So we can play the sound either stored on the device, the Android device, or from a network location, for instance, on Hasio's file system. I think it's easier to just play it from Hasio's file system, which is what I do when someone rings the bell. Then if you want to be able to access the Hasio file system from the tablet, you need to set up authentication. So if you don't already have this in Home Assistant, in the configuration.yaml file, you can set up auth providers, and you can set up trusted networks, and you can actually set up trusted users. And if you set up the tablet as a trusted user, then it allows them to access the file system on Hasio. And also, if the tablet logs out, you don't need passwords to log back in again. So it makes it work a bit better. To get that ID number for the trusted users, you just come into Home Assistant and go to configurations and look up users. And I'm using the user kitchen tablet, and the ID number is just here. So that ID number goes in the configuration file just there, like so. The next thing we need to do is set up a REST command. So the command is that we're setting up is kiosk command, and it links to the secrets file. In the secrets file, we set this up. So we have our password there and the IP address for your tablet, and that you just paste that into your secrets file. We've also got these two here. These two are to get the sensors set up as well. So we've got those two. We've also got a script and a services.yaml file in the description down below. Just copy those files, those two files just there, into Python scripts. So under config, Python scripts. If you haven't got it, make it. And just copy them in here. And it's just two little scripts that I've made, so you can control different aspects of the tablet from Home Assistant with a service call. And in configuration.yaml, we'll just make sure you have Python scripts included in that file. That way, if you come across into Home Assistant and you do look up services, you'll see a Python script.fully service, and it gives you all the parameters that you can pass to it. So you might want to change the brightness, change the screen turn on time, restart the app, which is what I do in an automation. We can change the sensitivity. And so you don't have to go back and look at the instructions to work it out. It's all just in Home Assistant already. So that's pretty handy to use. And also we've got these sensors that you can set up just here, and it gives you some information about the tablets, what they're doing, those two sensors. And there's also, if you wanted, a battery level sensor. So there's quite a few things you can do with Home Assistant and fully kiosk browser. It's pretty handy. One other thing is there's MQT settings. If you go to fully browser settings and come down to the bottom one, other settings, you can turn MQTT on. This is experimental though, and I found it's a little bit flaky, but I'm sure they'll get it working properly. And I've actually just got a binary sensor hooked up to it, just here. So if the tablet detects motion, then it turns the binary sensor on. Of course, because I've only got visual motion, it won't work at night, it only works during the day. Some other automations I've got set up is a doorbell chime one, a night light. So during the night, I've actually got a second motion sensor, an infrared one. So when I walk into the kitchen, it turns the tablet screen on full brightness for about 5 minutes. So that's just enough light to see by to get around the kitchen. And then I've got the reset tablet once every morning to stop it from locking up. And I've got this changing the screen time back to 30 seconds in the morning because I've got it set to 5 minutes a night. So it's just a few automations that I've got going. And also not an automation, but on the tablet, I found it a pretty handy secondary controller for my air conditioner, which is a MyAir system from Advantage Air. It's a ducted system, and I've actually been able to hook it up quickly with, I can control the heating and cooling and the power and the fan and the temperature. And I'm also should be able to include all the temp, I've got 10 zones, and should be able to include all the temperatures and be able to turn the zones on and off from the tablet as well, which has been a cool little handy addition. So look out for this, how to set up your MyAir Advantage Air system on Home Assistant. I'll be making a video on that soon.
I'm using Lovelace on my tablet right now and making use of the new dashboards feature in Home Assistant. Making a simple dashboard to suit your needs is the easiest method to use with this tablet. I have tried Home Panel 2 briefly and didn't particularly like it or find it suited my needs. Lastly, I tried HA Dashboard, which is an app daemon-based application, and I really liked it. I feel that the dashboards could be much more polished and they look very functional and work really well. The only thing is it's a lot more complicated to set up. Overall, I love and recommend Fully Kiosk, having used it for a few months and found it very functional, especially having the screen turn on as you approach. It works flawlessly so far. The only issue I've had is the screen locking on loading, and I've gotten around that by restarting the app every morning on an automation. The Vitabox wall mount is well made, slim, and makes the tablet look professional. And although it's not cheap, I think it's worth the money. However, using this setup to view video is slow and clunky, and while I suspect that a better tablet may improve it slightly, it is not the best system to use if you want it to be a security camera viewing hub, as it is too slow. If that is your main goal, then look elsewhere. I'd like to thank you all for watching, and if you want to see more videos on home automation and electrical installations, please subscribe, and if you like the video, please give us a like. Thanks.